These four forgotten colonial era railway stations surround Bengaluru and could add immense value to the city's suburban rail dreams. Built around the year 1915, the enchanting stations are nestled in lush greenery. These narrow gauge lines once carried gold from Kolar. The Bengaluru-Chikbalapur Light Railway Line was the first in the princely state of Mysore to be built under a private-public partnership model. After Bengaluru expanded rapidly, the halt stations fell into disuse and neglect. A Facebook post on the supposed demolition of the halt station in Devanahalli had led to frenetic activity from the group members, which even led to a legal representation being filed with the Divisional Railways Manager. The Railways was quick to clarify that the heritage railway stations would not be demolished.
Means today our team had inspected all the four stations. There was means no intention, no plan of demolishing even any one of these buildings, anytime, ever. We will be taking up this restoration of four buildings through corporate social responsibility. If not in January, in February 2021, certainly work will commence.
Suggestions are pouring in on what can be done to preserve the heritage structures. The restoration is expected to inspire Bengaluru's suburban rail.
It is absolutely one of the limbs of that suburban railway plan. Line is essentially a rural line through Bangalore rural, enabling people in the districts of Kolar and Chikbalapur to bring their produce into Bangalore city. And it's a no-brainer. It's only 2 kilometers away from there to the international railway station. International airport, right?
And the locations are just beautiful. That is one of the main assets, you know, with trees all around, and the setting is just amazing. Like Devanahalli station, for example, just across from Devanahalli station is Devanahalli Fort and the birthplace of Tipu Sultan. Both of these are ASI protected monuments. Along that route, you cross Chikadala, where, as you know, this used to be a megalithic site, early historic period site, which means that what I'm trying to say is that this entire region is a place where people have been living for at least 2,000 years. So if there's some way of making use of these stations to capture this and convey this sense of deep history to people, it would be really nice.
Awareness around Bengaluru's heritage is growing by the day, and the heritage train stations can't be ignored any longer.